Some of you might say, why we didn't say use find? Okay, find mean contents. Contents. It search for a substring if it is inside a string. So I don't want contents a string. ما بدي إنه يتضمن, بدي يبدأ. I want it to start with. So this is why I have told you to use substr. Search for this function, okay? Use substr and try to solve this problem. Yalla, go ahead, guys. Our lab for today is not too long. We have only 3 tasks. So I will give you in this maybe 15 minutes. Then I will go back to you, inshallah. Inshallah. Yalla. Now, please try to solve this. I will repeat again. I didn't use find or contents because find mean contents. This is what we have studied in the lecture. The find, which is search for a part of a string. But I don't want to search for a part. I didn't want to check if the string contains. I want to check if the string starts. So please try to use substr. Go ahead. Inshallah, 15 minutes, then we will go to the solution. I think you will solve this one. It is not that difficult, but it worth to try. Please try to solve. طيب, anyone can tell me what are the parameter for this substr? شو البرامتر اللي باخذها او شو الاشياء اللي باخذها؟ احكي لي اياها. Anyone؟ يعني شو البرامتر اللي تاخذه؟ يعني لما انا اكتب كذا sub when I write sub str. افتح اقواس, شو الاشياء اللي باخذها؟ كم برامتر؟ How many parameter this function takes؟ كم قيمة؟ يلا يا شباب. How many parameter does substr takes? How many parameters? This is our first problem. We should know the number of parameter. We are dividing our problem. How many problem does substr takes? This substr function inside C++. How many parameter here? For example, if there is no commas, it takes one parameter. If there is one comma, that means it takes two parameters. If there is two comma, that means it takes three parameters. And so on. Here are the parameters written. How many parameter does substr take? Maybe جواب.
أتوقع يضبط واحد يعني, لأن أنت تعرف مثلا السعودية برقم واحد اللي هو 00960.
Okay, but this sub, طب the word sub str شو معناها؟ sub str شو معنى sub أول شيء؟ معنى جزء, صح؟ sub جزء من string, sub of string, sub of string. أنا بدي آخذ sub جزء من نص. طيب. إذا تخيل إنه أنا أعطيتك whatever let's say something like قطعة قماش, أوكي؟ أو خلينا نقول روب حبل. روب حبل عادي, وقلت لك بدي قطعة من هذا الحبل. أوكي, قطعة محددة. شو الأسئلة؟ What are the questions that you are asking me?
وش الطول وش العرض؟
لا, نفرض إنه طول, يعني طول زي السترينج, يعني one dimension array, بدنا الطول, صح؟ وكمان لو فرضنا إنه ملون أو مختلف أو
المكان, الموقع.
أيوه, ممتاز. Location. خلينا نكتب في الإنجليش, معلش. Length, الطول. من وين ابدا؟ اللوكيشن, صح؟
ايه, البوزيشن اول بعدين اللينث.
تمام, البوزيشن او اللوكيشن واللينث. وكمان بدي احدد من اي حبل. لو فرضنا انا عندي محل، فرضنا شوب كونتينز ا لوت اوف روبس، مجموعه من الحبال يعني، راح تقول لي اي حبل بدك صح؟ من اي قطعه قماش اقص لك، او فروم ويتش روب يو وانت تو جيت صح؟ سو اي نيد ذا روب، نفس الحبل يعني صح ولا لا؟ لازم احدد له ثلاث شغلات، شو اللي what is the thing that I'm going to take from, what is the length, what is when, what is the location or what is the starting position. For example, this rope I want to start from 3 centimeters, 30 centimeters من هذا الروب 1 في length كذا، وبدي متاخذ منه 10 centimeters like this. بتروح بتجيب سيزر whatever and you will cut the rope، هتقطع الحبلات صح؟ هذه نفس الشيء، هذا السب السيار بأخذ جزء من السرينج، فهو أكيد بحاجة، بس أنا مش حافظ الترتيب، بحاجة للبوزيشن موقع من وين بدك تستارت، بحاجة لللينكث، بحاجة لمين السرينج اللي بدك تاخذ منه، شو هو السترينج؟ سترينج 1، سترينج 2، سترينج 3. So sub STR, I don't just remember the order of this parameter. It will take three things. This is makes sense for us. STR, lower string, will length, ومن وين ابدا؟ Starting position. Okay? The starting position. So this is in final we have this string, for example, this is my number 0966 0926, and we have also 00971. So what is the starting position here for this string that I'm going to read it from the keyboard? I'm going to write CN. وريد ال STR. شو أنا راح، كيف راح أشوف إنه بيبدأ بي؟ شو راح يكون البوزيشن راح أدور منه؟ Is it position 5 or 3 or 0? The starting position, شو هو؟
0.
0. ممتاز، صح. ممتاز. 0. راح ياخذ 0. مع السترينج، بس أنا مش حافظ الترتيب الآن، نشوف الترتيب مع الحل. راح ناخذ الـ STR and الـ starting position والـ length. كم الـ length عندي؟ 5، صح؟ كده، فهذا اللينكث هو دائما 5، والستارتنج بوزيشن هو 0، والسترينج هو السترينج اللي انا that I have defined or that I have read from the keyboard، وانحلت خلاص. Then I will check if substring equal something like this, that means Saudi Arabia, otherwise say Jordan, otherwise United Arab Emirates. So I have here 0, then I have the starting position is 0 and the length is always fixed. Then we have the string here. So I will go to the solution now. Clear, I will clear the drawing and we will check it is easy, inshallah. But we need to think. This is to train you how to use this parameter. I have included now I am in the solution. I hope that the screen is not frozen here.
It's okay.
Yes, that's good. When I have read the phone number here, cn.getLine, if you remember, cn, phone number. This is used with the string. Then I have checked this. If phone number dot sub str. إذا الفون نمبر اللي أنا قرأته في at the beginning هنا 0 في طول 5 يساوي كذا، then this is our country is Saudi Arabia. Otherwise, it is United Arab Emirates. Otherwise, this is Jordan. Else, بالنسبة إلي أنه إذا كان غير كذا هو غير معروف. Now, why I didn't use find? لأنه الفايند بتدور على كلمة داخل الفون نمبر سواء كان في البداية أو في الوسط أو النهاية فايند. أنا ما بدي في I don't want to be in the beginning, in the middle or in the last. I want in the beginning. So using find is not correct. لأنه if we suppose that we have this number, لو فرضنا 9 6 here, then we have الرقم لو فرضنا أن الرقم كان 0 0 9 9 6 2 6 2 okay, فهذه راح ترجع true وهذه راح ترجع true لأنهم راح يعتبروا جوردن لأنه في الميدل أو في الآخر وهنا لو فرضنا أنه في هذا الباب وهنا راح يعتبروا سعودي أرابيا فأنا بدي أقول له مش find not contains I want to say starts I think if you go to other language you will see a function called start with something like this starts with or starts راح تشوفوا هذا في بعض اللغات I think I don't really remember we have start with or starts or whatever so this is the solution here try to solve this inshallah in 5 minutes then we will go to our next task now here I believe that we have something like this we have did something like this in our example in the lecture here. Now I want you in task number 2 to write a program to toggle a given string. Toggle mean change the case from capital to small and from small to capital. So if I have given you this string, if you have entered, sorry, this string, you are going to convert it to this one. Yellow. Think about this and try to solve it. Of course, you need to use some function here to check if it is capital or if it is small, then you need to convert based on your if statement. Yeah. And you need to go over this string character by character. Think about this. It's not that difficult. I hope you will solve it within 15 minutes, inshallah. الفكرة منه إنك the idea here is to go to this string character by character. نروح على A. و A و B B كذا capital و D و E و G هذا انت الآن you will go to this through this string character by character it is array of character right مش هي array مش هذه array of character
نعم
أي string هو array of character أي string حتى لو استخدمت معاه string هذا أنا ذكرته في المحاضرة حتى لو استخدمت if you have used string with any if you have used string or C string any string C بتعامل معه if you want to deal with this string ask array of character you can so الآن تخيل إنه هذه array عندك تخيلها one dimension array and you are checking for example the number mod by 2 شو بتعمل you will do a for loop صح
نعم
And you will write if statement هنا وراح تستخدم المود تقول لي إذا مود 2 اعمل كاونتر او وات ايفر، يعني بتعمل عمليه معينه صح؟
نعم.
The same here. You are going to write a for loop. Check. إذا كان الكاركتر if إذا كان في lower case. إذا كان lower case. I don't also remember the function exactly here. Okay. إذا كان في lower case. أنت فكر فيه. الكاركتر اللي هو let's say نسمي C of I character. هذه array name بدك تحوله ل upper. في عندنا function اسمه to upper. I mentioned the function name because we have this, these function are in the slide. We have to change it to upper and put it in the same one.
أنا استعملت ASCII code.
It's up to you, whatever. You can use the ASCII code or we have built-in function. We have is lower to check. شوف is lower شوي أسهل صح؟ بدل ما أنت تعمل if ASCII between كذا and كذا. Use is lower. ماشي؟ وإذا كان upper بيعمل لك upper. حتى is lower إذا كان digit ما بشيكه أصلا. إذا كان في digit ما بشيكه يعني بignore it, will skip it. Okay. بحوله لأبر، وإلا إذا كان لور هو حوله لأبر، وإلا حوله للور كل أبر. هذا الحل يعني راح أورجيك السوليوشن أنا الآن. I will show you the solution, but if you are insisting, then you are going to put it here. فهذه الفكرة بتشيك أنت إذا كان لور بتحوله لأبر وبتحطه في مكانه in the same place. وإذا وإلا فهو راح يكون إذا مش lower it will be upper في الإلس هو يا lower يا upper. إذا lower هيتحول راح يتحول إذا كان upper راح يتحول للور وتحطه كده. فهي the same idea. The most important idea is to check if we have use C string or string. Any string you can you can treat any mean all صح؟ أي string as array of character حتى لو انت مش معرفه كاري. If you didn't define it as array you can deal with it as array of character. Okay. طبعا some other language is have more libraries than C++ dealing with string. يعني راح تشوف بعض البروجرامينج لانجويج مباشره بتعطيه to upper بحول لك السترينج كامل لأبر. And you don't pass for him character. You can pass for him the whole string. منها ال visual basic بحسب علمي هذه. Maybe I worked on this maybe 10 or 15 years ago. We have to in visual basic. I think L case. هذا بأخذ string وبحوله. All string, string كامل مش character. مثلا في عنا U case. يا lower case يا U case. صراحة ناسي لأنه كثير programming language اشتغلت عليه. يعني there are a lot of programming language I have worked on. So I forget. Maybe it's individual basic L case وهذا بأخذ string كامل. No need to pass by them by character by character. Individual basic. And you have U case. And also, of course, يعني in Java there are also functions. برضو تحول لك string كامل, the whole string directly بدون ما تعمل هذه for loop. But we see أنا ما مر علي. Maybe there are. I don't know. But I think no. Yeah. In C. So in C you need to check them character by character and convert them. Convert them. فبس هل in other programming language is there other function built-in function to convert the whole string? Yes. In Visual Basic and Java I am sure. And of course Python. I didn't try Python but in Java and VB yes they are exist. The built-in function are there. The built-in function are there. So this is our task. I will go to the solution directly, inshallah. Here I have also, I have read the word here. I have checked the length. The can length مش خمسة. For example here, I have word should contains 5 character. هذه إذا حاب تضيفها هنا, you can add this. لازم يكون the length of the string should be 5. إذا مش 5 اكتب هذا المسج وخلاص, ما تروح على else. Don't go to the else part. Otherwise, go to the else part, and هنا في عنا عملية toggling, toggle. You can find the word toggle in Word actually, or some application toggle, change the word, the cases of the letter. So here is the solution. I did my for loop for I 0 to 5, I plus plus. If is lower than the word of I, هذا الوورد اللي هي الاري هيها. If it is lower, I have changed it to upper. Otherwise, I will change it to lower and put it in the same character here, in the same array. So this is what would happen here. I will go for loop, check. If it's lower, let's suppose that A, B, for example, F, E, and G. I will check if now I equals 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, it's supposed to be 5, because we have the non-terminated here, we will check. If A equal here, is it small letter? Yes, I will convert it to capital letter and put it here again in the same function. If it is this one is small letter, yes, I will convert it to capital and put it here. I will check if the third one is lower. No, it is in upper, so I will change it to lower. It will become L. And this is low, is in the upper case, it is not in the lower. I will change it to E, and this one will be changed to G. So something like this. So this is the solution here. Here the strlen is to check the length of the string. Try this and we will go to the third task inshallah. And I need to explain an idea, a new idea about the third task for you. I will ask you one question about this inshallah, lecture. Now we have here to focus in, أنا برضو متوقع أن الطلاب يوقعوا في هذا المطب أو في in this one, this trick. We have what we call here complexity. يعني إنه أنا بقدر أحل الكود ولكن بطريقة معقدة ممكن أحل. But this will consume time and effort. Okay, and we have simplicity. لا تنسى هذا للأبد. Simplicity. شو يعني simplicity يا عبد الله؟ اللي هي تبسيط الأمور. أوكي. قبل ما أنا أدور على الحل الصعب، خليني أدور على السهل. واضح؟ يعني قبل ما أنا أعمل try to convert using ASCII code, I will check. I am now using string and C string. Is there any function that convert from capital to small or small to capital? Based on that, I will choose. If there is no function, then I will go to the complexity here. But if there are function, I will stay, I will use the simple code. Why simple code? Because you will be developer. راح تكون انت موظف او مبرمج مثلا لو فرضنا. والديفلوبر مين سالري. اوكي راح يعطوك راتب. والتايم بالشركات راح تكون راح تشوف خاصه بروفيشنال كومبل راح يكون الوت اوف بريشر. فبالنسبه لهم التايم از ماني، بالنسبه للشركه هذه التايم ماني. يعني اذا انا بدفع لك راتب وانت مش قاعد بتشتغل ماني. If I am paying you a salary and you are, for example, I ask you to solve a task, and you can solve it in a simple way in one day. But you decide to use the complex code, and you will you consume, for example, 7 days, or 5 days, 7, whatever, any number here, any days, 1 week. So you they are paying you a salary to do a task for 1 day, in 1 day, okay? And you have consumed in this task 7 days. You are clever, and you are using the complex way, and you have done a great solution. But they will ask you why they don't understand this. Oh, you have used a complex code, and you have done this in a clever way. But this is actually complexity. And you have for this task assumed 7 days. Why are they expecting from you to solve the task in 1 day? So think about simplicity before going to complexity. Think if there are equal, if there are some function will help you. I said this in the lecture, again, I will repeat it. Don't invent the wheel. ما تصنع العجل للسيارة, العجل موجود. فإذا أنت طلب منك someone ask you to invite a car or invent a car, تخترع السيارة يعني, don't invent the wheel, الويل موجود فرض. خلص ما في داعي تصنع العجل, هو موجود. ليش تعمله أنت؟ المثال حاب أذكره للطلاب اللي استخدمنا فيه اللي هو الفايند. We were searching for a part of the world inside an email, which is Gov. I have an email and I want to search for the word go. And we have explained if I'm going to use the complex way. For example, let's suppose that we have this string G, G, V, G, O, V. I'm going to search for a part of a string. So first of all, I will search here for this one. And go to the first three characters, G, G, G. G, 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 not equal go. The second step, I will start from this one. So I will have G, V, G. And for the second, not, for the second, I will concatenate these together. So the word will be G, V, G, G, V, G. It is wrong. And the first one, G, G, V also. The first one is wrong. Then I will go to the V here. Then I have V, G, O. This is wrong also. But then in the last, I will find, I will go to G, then I will find here the word go. شوف هذا قديش complex. كم أخذ مني وقت. It will take from me a lot of time. Oh, I am clever. I have solved this. أنا ذكي وحليته صحيح ما حد بينكر هذا الكلام بس هذا الحل أخذ منك فرضنا 7 days بينما ممكن أنت تحله بطريقة بسيطة في 1 day in a simple مش بس هذه المشكلة ممكن يجي أنت الآن you might leave the company okay leave or روح تشتغل في مشروع ثاني another project ويجي شخص ثاني ممكن junior مبتدئ بده يشتغل لما يشوف هذا الكود كذا اللي بيعمل هذا الكلام راح he will be confused يعني ما راح يفهم يقول لك شو هذا الكود والله I don't understand okay ف will be confused I mean by confused انه ما يعني راح يشوف شو هذا بيعمل كود he will maybe also consume another 4 days to understand this and as I said before time is money for this for the company. يعني بالنسبة لهم أنا بدي أعمل تاسكات وأنهيها للكستمر عشان يدفعوا لي هذا بالنهاية هو شغل هو كوميرشال تجاري يعني. فدائما ركز عشان كذا دائما هي بعيدها ركز focus on simplicity. دائما focus على simplicity اوكي على الأمور الأبسط حاول حل الشيء بالطريقة الأبسط. Always, yeah. Try to solve this like in this. This is for task two. Now, for task 3 here, and this is the task here, and it is not that difficult. Have you finished task 2, guys? For task 2, sorry, I went over the anyone has finished task 2? ولا حدا ما شاء الله شباب. Have you finished task 2? Yes, me or
yes,
not? Thank you. يعني هذا فرحنا والله بنت هو مو صعب ولكن بالاونلاين هذا سلطان كويس برضو ممتاز يعني. الان for task 3 for task 3 شو كان هي what about task 3 here write a program to ask to enter a user to enter first name, mid name and last name and join them together and convert them to capital letter. يعني اللي بدنا اياه منكم دخل الاسم الاول الاسم الثاني الثالث تحولهم لكابيتال وتربطهم يصيروا فول نيم. اوكي this suppose now this one to you are going to join this string together and before joining them you are going to convert them to capital letter. Maybe this is what is happening inside PeopleSoft. I think maybe some of your names, I think your names are in capital letter. I am not sure about this. So try to solve this here. Ask the user to enter the first name, middle name, and last name. Join them together and convert them to capital letter. And convert them to capital letter. Okay, also Abdullah has solved task 2, that's good. Now we are going to task 3. Enter the first name, the second name, third name, convert them to capital letter, then join them together. Okay, I will give you in this also another 15 minutes. Then I will go to the solution and I won't just explain another idea. Without a task, another I will talk about something after finishing task number 3. Don't forget the quiz for today also. It is at 9 p.m. I will leave the quiz open for 5 minutes. Quiz duration is 20 minutes. And we have multiple and it's a question. So do your best and good luck.
Looks as it's 5 questions.
I don't. I will not mention the number. The number is okay. I don't know that it is not allowed to mention the number, but it is good for the time. Yani for the time of the quiz, it's I think appropriate for all of you. Yani ملائم لكم جميعا مناسب يعني. Now let's go about task 3. Write a program to ask user to enter first, mid, and last name and join them together and convert them to capital letter. زي ما انتم شايفين هنا. بس انا هنا كاتب خالدي كذا. يا خالدي هذا. احمد علي خالدي. حول في string واحد جمعناهم وطبعناهم بالطريقة هذه. We have printed them on the screen. يلا go ahead ان شاء الله we have 13 minutes لل 11 وثلث ان شاء الله 11:20 okay guys I now I will go to the solution task number 3 I hope the screen is not frozen here. This is what I have done here. I have, or what we have done, I have entered the first name, the second name, then the last name here. Then First name, second name, and last name. We have joined them together using full name. Then I have did, I have done sorry, or I have written my for loop. So the first name here, and the second and the third will be inside the full name, and they will be concatenate because I have added the pluses here. After that, here I have check go through the full name for I equal to zero, for I while I less than full name dot length minus one here. Don't forget this because I am going to iterate the value here. Sorry, no, here no need for the J. I don't regress anything here. Remove this one, please. Then I have checked if it is in the lowercase, I have converted it to uppercase using this statement. Using this statement here. And finally, I have printed the value here. Printed them character by character. You can print them as array also, cout, or using a for loop to print them. If this will work with you, it's better, cout, full name. It's okay, because here, if this works, to print up, no need to use my for loop here. So what I have done here is I have made my code more complex. While I might be able to use cout full name here. This is the first idea. I can write this. If this can be done, that's okay. Cout full name. So here I am joining them together, and here I am converting them to capital letter, and here I am printing them using a for loop, or I can use cout full name. Now, just give me 1 minute, Abdullah. I will, inshallah, answer you if I can. Just give me seconds here. I want to... modify the material here. Give me seconds. يس عبد الله جو اهيد
دكتور اقدر اسوي اللي بحركه ثانيه
يس هذا الفكره اللي بدي احكي احكيها انا يس شو هي الحركه
حقت اذا كان كابيتال اخليه يطبع نفسه كابيتال زي ما هو اذا كان سمول اخليه يزيد عليه الرقم لما يوصل الكابيتال يعني
يس ولكن بدون ما نزيد الرقم خلص عملته ابر افضل يعني انا كذا رايي يعني عشان if any developer came with you came after you and read the code, he might not interested. يعني ما يعرف الاسكي كود. It's better, this is it's more readable. This is my point of view. يعني هذا من وجهة نظري, but it's okay. You can, يعني هنا تزيد الاسكي كود بلس 32, صح؟ كده يعني. Yes, it's okay, but يعني try always to use يعني اسم المقروء أكثر, لأنه ممكن بعض يجي مبرمج ثاني مثلا يقرأ كودك ما يعرف يعني بلس 32. واضح انا في البدايه استخدمنا الكلام هذا طبعا لانه لسه ما دخلنا اللايبرري هذه ونساعدك انك تفهم انه الكاركتر ممكن we can deal with the character as integer or as we can change them because we can represent their ASCII code. So يعني it's up to you. But myself I prefer to يعني to use to up يعني تكون مقروءة أكثر للشخص يعني مفهومة أي واحد بقرأها any developer or any CS student will understand this. Now not I need another the third idea here. Let's suppose that your idea is the second and here is the first Harry and here is the second then I want this one. هذه الجملة نقدر can we do this in other way using C string نقدر احنا نعمل هذا الكلام في طريقة ثانية if name is name and last name join them together شو رأيكم yes عبد الله
اتوقع نقدر نضيفهم بالحركه اللي هي اللي نكتب سي اوت يور فول نيم بعدين السهمين يسار ونكتب ذا ومسافه بعدين نقطتين مسافه
يس لا يس without assignment I mean using another function using other function يس عبد الله ايوه الان انا بدي ابين فيك خليني اكتبها على اللون الابيض عشان تكون واضحه اكثر thank you Abdullah يعني good idea انه you can bring them together or see out the screen and thank you I don't Abdullah Shreddy and thanks for Abdullah Shimari also let me explain this here هذه بدي اشرحها هنا اذا ممكن شوفوا كيف we can before I write the code we can mix الفانكشن داخل بعضها وراح تشوفوا اكواد كثيره كذا يعني بقدر احل هذه في جملة واحدة بقدر استخدم هنا شوفوا كده strcat اول شيء بدي ادمج الاول مع الثاني بقول له if name اوكي مع second name يعني هذا في جملة واحدة one shot زي ما بقول طيب هذا راح يدمج لي الفانكشن اثنين مع بعض اللي هو الفيرست نيم والسكند نيم دمجتهم الان بقدر اقول له كمان هنا بس بدي امسح هذا في المحل هنا بقدر اقول له برضو هذه النتيجة شوفوا كيف هذه النتيجة برضو ادمجها الناتج من هذه ادمجه مع اللي هو النيم وحطه كله في فول نيم شوفوا كيف يعني انا استخدمت فانكشن جوا فانكشن فانكشن جوا فانكشن كان اي يوز انذر فانكشن هير يس ممكن استخدم هنا length ممكن استخدم any function inside this function the idea here that I can mix the function together بس بدي اكون حاضر في البارامتر يعني اللي بتدخل الان خلينا نراجع مره ثانيه ال strcat لو فرضنا الاف نيم هو مثلا فادي والسكند نيم هذا بدناش هادي بلاش تخربطه مثلا علي الثيرد نيم اللي هو احمد او اللاست نيم الان الاس تي ار كات الاولى بتاخذ فادي وعلي هذه فادي وعلي تدمجهم مع بعض فهذه هنا رجعت شيء مدموج something concatenated here فادي عند علي now became one more وبعدين قلت له وادمج فادي وعلي بعد الدمجه الاولى the first one وهذه لاحظ انه الاس تي ار كانت هنا بتاخذ two parameter if name وان name it takes two parameter So I have to be restrict, or I have to follow the rules. Two parameter I have, go to strcat, two parameter, first name and the second name. And I have concatenated them together. Now, هذه ال strcat رجعت لي فادي علي مربوطين. يعني هذه فيها فادي علي مربوط joined together or concatenated together. هذا الآن بقدر كمان أقول له برضو اعمل كونكاتينيت مع هذه النتيجة كاملة مع مين؟ مع اللاست نيم اللي هو أحمد. فإن ذات كيس I will the full name will be concatenated فادي علي أحمد. فادي علي أحمد. Okay. So we can solve this by this way. And the most important idea that I want to represent to you or explain to you that we can use function inside a function. We can use this one, and it is not necessary to be the same. Maybe we can use function, and here we can use different function. This depends on our needs. Okay, على حاجتنا يعني لله. So this is another way to solve the problem. It's up to you. Do you want to use this one or this one? It is up to you. This is for strcat for the C string, and we have dot, I think, in string concatenate or concat. We have a process also. Sorry, we have a process here. We can add the pluses for a string. This is a way, and this is another way. بس انتو شو رأيكم? Which is the easier way to read? Is this one or this one? شو رأيكم?
الأولى.
الأولى يعني أيوة أبسط بالنسبة لكم وإلي كمان. هذه أبسط. فأنا بفضل هذه. Simple يعني هذا زي ما انتو شايفين. هذا first statement is more simple. ولكن أنا الفكرة اللي بدي أوضحها هنا مش الكونكات فقط. الفكرة اللي أنا بدي أوضحها I want to hear the idea that I want to clarify that we can use a function, built-in function inside a built-in function. It's okay. But we need to be careful with the parameter. فهذا الأول أخذ two parameter زي ما أنتم شايفين if name and second name. And also the strcat هذا الخارجي أخذت two parameter هذا الأول كما هذا الثاني ف we need to be careful with this.
دكتور حتى الأول نقدر نحط مسافة بين أسماء.
Yes. Yes عشان تحل مشكلة برضو نعم تقدر أنت هنا تقول له كذا يعني هنا تقول له عشان ما يصير الأرقام المغرم كده تقول له أو ممكن بعد ما تعمل if name هنا تقرأ الاسم تقول له if name تساوي تحل مشاكل طبعا هي مشاكل بتواجهك وبتحلها if name plus كده عشان تضيف مسافة بعد الاسم if name تساوي if name زائد space نفس الشيء second name والthird name وبعدين تدمجهم كده يعني هذا enhance our solution هذا ليش عشان كده we always call this development development يعني تطويرية يعني انت بتكتب برنامج ما راح تقدر تعمل cover all cases from the first time واحنا بنتعمد we don't want to make the example very complex. So, but this is a good idea. Now we have discovered إنه عنا الكلمات طبعاً أكيد راح تلزق في بعضها البعض يعني. It will be joined together without spaces. So الحل إنك بس يدخل الاسم تضيفه أنت فراغ plus space. When we enter the second name, we can add also space for this one at the end, and we can also only the first and the second. For the last time, we don't need to add a space. We can add for the first one the space and save it again inside it. And we can add for the second one also a space and save it inside the second name. then we will join them together, then we will convert them to capital letter, and again we can use this function. Okay, that's all for our lab for today.